Welcome back to my YouTube channel. When you realize that something is possible, possibilities begin to appear. Scientific disciplines are considered to be separate phenomena. However, this view is wrong because science is a universal passport. Science is about thinking critically and exploring. Science isn't a point, it's a question mark. For example, people learn by memorizing the solar system and the names of the planets. But this isn't a helpful learning method because names have no value. Instead, a question mark might ask the following questions. Which of the hundreds of thousands of small objects orbiting the sun are exceptional? Are there any similarities? What makes them exceptional? What secrets have they uncovered? Unfortunately, today there is an education system in which the person who gives the correct answer is rewarded, not the one who asks a question. The world is experiencing the chaos created by this faulty education system in every field. Science is the art of asking the right questions, not just giving answers. We need to teach people to understand the way of thinking, because it is questions that shape our understanding, and the questions we ask lead us to more questions. This may seem like a complex system to some, but it is not complicated because it is based on critical thinking. This is a valid passport for both concrete and abstract questions. For example, let's take the concept of love. Many artists say that love is a mysterious force. Priests and other clergy claim it is the manifestation of the divine. On the other hand, biochemists say that the phenomenon called love is the feedback loop of dopamine, testosterone, phenylethylamine, and noradrenaline. There is an important difference between scientists and the people I have mentioned. This difference is that we can show our work. Some may misunderstand this because their thought system is one-sided. Some may see it as a blow to love. Some may say to me, "You aren't a romantic." However, I have to admit an important fact. We are who we are because of evolution, and from one point of view, at its core, evolution is the regular production of increasingly sophisticated killing machines. We are also biochemical machines that process information in the web of life. The killing machines I just mentioned are also survival machines. The two are inseparable. This view may be seen by many as a very cold view, but remember that beliefs warm, comfort, but not enlighten. Knowledge enlightens people. We can live in the cold, but we cannot live in the dark. So this isn't a cold view, but an optimistic view. We weren't born from fallen angels, but from ascendant apes, and apes were above all armed killers. So, why are we surprised? Our weapons, our missiles, our bombs, our massacres, our irreconcilable crowds, and our worthless deals. I don't want it to be judged from a humanistic point of view, but still, the miracle of man isn't how deep he sinks, but how high he rises. You know, in the world, people are known for their poetry, not their corpses. We create heroes, we create ideologies and mythologies. We lie, and we build a life on that lie. But those who think that we will be known among the stars, not by our corpses, but by our poems, as in the world today, are mistaken. This thinking is a dangerous mistake, because we are unknown among the stars. Our sun doesn't think about human nature. The galaxy doesn't judge us. The universe doesn't care about us. From what we know so far, we are alone in the cosmic drama. We have evolved into what we are today because the current model of humanity has survived while our previous iterations failed to do so. It's that simple. I should add some things to what I just said about the poems. I like poetry too, but poets are sometimes more dangerous than murderers. A serial killer may have dozens of victims, but poets can ruin generations. If you are aware, the subject has extended from science to poetry. Because life is the connectional integrity of intertwined information encodings. Each piece interacts with many other pieces that are different from itself. It will be much more useful for you to see what I have said as a whole and to make sense of it reasonably. Understanding and making sense of the whole can be difficult at first for our imperfect minds, because life is too complex and infinite for the human brain to invent. Our minds may be inadequate for this. However, our aim should be to perceive this difficult one. Because life has no distinction like natural sciences, fine arts, and architecture, it is a universal existence. As subjects of life, we both try to perceive it and in existence in it. That's why you have to be careful when rebuilding life in your mind. Because when the rebuilding process is left unattended, it regresses to a dangerous primitive process in which the mind hurls the data from the environment into itself without categorizing it. That's why we have to categorize the data very carefully and associate it with theories that can make sense of the data. In this way, we can establish multiple relationships, interact with the whole, and be able to make sense of life rationally. Although we were born from humanoid apes, the most important feature that distinguishes us from animals today is the mind. You know, it is the mind that separates man from animal. When a man gives up using his mind, animal urges come out. If we put this sentence based on our lives and try to live a reasonable life, even if it will take some time together, there will be very little that we cannot achieve. In this video, I try to explain to you most simply what we are, where we have evolved, and what we can do. If you have any other questions, I would be very happy if you let me know in the comments. I am honored to be with you on this journey I have embarked on. Thanks for watching. Take care of yourself until we meet again. Stay with science. I love you all.